Hello, welcome back, Nick Lentz's Comic Corner, classics slash non-classics. This is episode number 200, excuse me, because for a while now I've been so used to saying 200 something, but now since yesterday I did my 300th episode, I am now at episode 301 and double shot number 232. All right. First up is Young All-Stars Volume 2, Glory Days, written by Matthew Sturges and artwork by Freddie Williams II. Now, some of you might be asking yourselves, what the heck is this series? I mean, some people who are just getting into comics now may have not heard of this series, but I have. This series itself didn't last too long. This series was 20-something issues? Hang on, let me take a look at this. All Stars was... It was a short-lived series. It lasted 18 issues, and it's comprised of the more younger members, people who have been members of the JSA. Now, they're called the All-Stars. The series is called JSA All-Stars because it's a spin-off of JSA. And this is not the first type of team that's happened like this to the JSA. Back in the 80s, there was a team called Infinity Inc., which was comprised of people who are young, who, like this one, young people who, except the only difference is that was started because different reason. Differences, basically. Now, there was this group of young heroes, some of whom claimed to be the children of some of the founding members of the JSA. People like Jade, Obsidian, who were actually confirmed later on to be the actual children of Alan Scott, the original Green Lantern. And a few other characters, one of whom happened to be the son of a former supervillain. They didn't want to join JSA, but they were turned down. So, because they probably thought they had different ideology at that point. So these younger heroes formed their own separate team known as Infinity Inc. and was led by a person who was a member of the JSA, the Star Spangled Kid, who changed his name to Skyman. Now, a few of these members of the All-Star team were members of that particular group back in the 80s. Power Girl herself was part of that group. Sand was not. Now, this group is comprised of Wildcat. Now, I believe this is the son of the original Wildcat, Ted Grant. I believe this. I have to look it up here. If I can get this work. Thank you. The group is comprised of Mogog, who is not in this book. Damage, who died prior to this. The second Iron Man, Atom Smasher, Stand, Stargirl, Jeff Johns' creation, Cyclone, yeah, I was right, he is the son of Tom Bronson, who was the son of the original Wildcat, Citizen Steel, Judah Master, King Chimera, Anna Fontaine, and an AI named Roxy. That is who's members of this group. Now, at the time of this, Damage himself had just died in the previous arc of the series. Yeah. Mogog himself was killed later on in a different series, but he was not part of this one. But at one point during this particular trade, they actually revisited the old headquarters of the Infinity Inc. Organization. Now, this organization, All-Stars, is led by a person who actually was the leader of the JSA at one point in time. Power Girl. Yep, the woman who happened to be the Earth 2 counterpart of Supergirl, and still kind of around this very day, the rebooted version of her, and she's noteworthy for having a boob window. Yep, the boob window. Yep, people know about her. Now, some of you are thinking, like, who are the characters I talk about? Like, who are the characters on this cover of this particular book? Now, Power Girl is obviously, anybody can tell who she is just by looking at her. But let me introduce you to the other members. This woman over here, that's Cyclone. She's a daughter of a woman who was known as Red Tornado back in the 40s. Let's see. This is Atom Smasher. He is the godson of the original Adam, Al Pritt. This is Judo Master. She's the second Judo Master. She's like the third or fourth person to the Judo Master. And she's on the, she's in the Earth 2 Society series. She's, she's the commander of the World Army. This is, Sandy Henderson, who has become new Sandman. This is Citizen Steel. His grandfather was the original, Steel, back in the, well, when he had a series back in the 70s. His cousin was the second one, and both of whom were creations of the awesome Jerry Conway. This one was a creation of, I think, Geoff Johns. Yes. He also created Roxy as well. He also created Cyclone as well. This is the second Iron Man. This is Rick Tyler. He was a member of the Infinity Inc. They mentioned Brainwave in here. He was not part of this group. This is King Chimera. That's really his name. Stargirl, another Geoff Johns creation. And I think that one in the back, I think this one is the other person. This one is Bonnie. That's who this person is in the back. That's who that is. Now, though, in the case of this particular version, this was started for a similar type of reason. Though, in the case of this one, it was not just because of ideologies, it was another reason. These people who were members of the JSA had a disagreement with the older members, thinking that Mogheim is even pointing this out, that their methods are outdated. Yes, their methods are outdated. But in this particular one, they just do very superhero stuff. This book is just pure fun to read. This is one of three trades. Now, at one point in the series, there was a brief backup feature for Our Man himself and... trying to think, what was her name? Oh, yes. The second Liberty Bell, who he later married, and she got pregnant prior to Flashpoint. This series was canceled because of Flashpoint, not because of low sales. The series was canceled just to make room for Flashpoint. That's really the only reason why the series was canceled. But anybody who was fans of Infinity Inc. back in the 80s, you would love this series. This is just young people who who were associated with the JSA, and just pure enjoyment. Also, I should also point out that Sand himself was at one point the leader of the JSA. Yeah, he was the first person who led the group when Robinson finished up his first arc of the JSA series. And he was leader up until Mr. Terrific took over. They voted him leader because of security concerns, what happened in JSA Secret Files in Origins number 2. And Mr. Terrific remained the chairman for some time, even after the book was relaunched as Justice Society of America Volume 3. Then eventually Power Girl herself took over as leader. And they went to very different leaders over the years. The original one was Jay Garrick back in the 40s. I get that book 9 out of 10. Next up is Plastic Man Archives, Volume 5. Yeah, Plastic Man. Yeah, there's no getting around the fact this guy is kind of a joke. But he's written to be very serious in here, which I do appreciate that. This topic, his adventures are very jokey. And this is nothing on... And who is this character writing on his back? That is Wonky Winks. He is his comedic psychic character. Some of the superheroes back in the 40s were known for having comedic sidekicks. Alan Scott had this with Dobby Diggles. Jay Garrick had with a Three Stooges parody. There was a few characters who had comedy sidekicks, mainly there for comic relief. That's simply the whole purpose of them. There's nothing really big noteworthy that happens in here. I mean, yeah, you have Plastic Man doing his various work for the FBI because he was a former gangster. He works for the FBI now. A lot of this stuff is like one shot. Now, what's in here? Basically, it's his stories from Police Comics, the comic he made his debut in, for issues 50 to 58 and issue 4 of the original Plastic Man series. Now, these issues were originally published by Quality Comics, a comic company that no longer exists. Their properties are owned by DC Comics. They have owned them since the late 50s, I believe so. Oh, and that book contained issue 7 to 13. Just FYI. But these stories are just pretty pure classic. Now, the guy who wrote these issues, the guy's name is Jack Cole. and he wrote, drew, and inked all the issues in here. And he did this for nearly 20 years. I am not kidding about this. The character made his debut in 1941, and the character ceased publication in 1953. Actually, it was 1950. He did this for, I'd say, almost 10 years. He did this. He basically wrote, drew, and inked this character. All the stories in here are just pure fun. Let me show off some artwork in here. Yeah, it's very classic style. Very smooth. Plastic Man himself, how he's drawn, has never really changed over the years. Oh, I almost forgot to show off some artwork from Freddie Williams II. I almost forgot that. Here we go. Here's some Freddie Williams II. The guy, but both these two, now, he is a very good artist, I should point out. And Jack Cole does a really good job of drawing the series, along with inking it and writing it. And even though that Plastic Man himself is written to be very serious, Wonky Winks, I'm serious, that's really his name. Apparently he has a thing for sleeping. Yes, that is apparently his thing. He apparently has the ability to fall asleep a lot. And he's just there for comic relief. But this is just pure fun. 9 out of 10. The only also give 9 out of 10 as well. Alright, that's it for this episode. Stay tuned for the next episode, which should be episode 302 and Double Shot number 233. Until then, I will see you there. Bye.